to a must-win game. I don't like to use that term in November, that's for sure. But as you're ever going to find, the Eagles at 4-5, Kurt, have the toughest remaining schedule in the National Football League. They're banged up in the secondary. Carson Wentz has got to have a great game. Kurt, didn't you just interview the guy? How did that go?
Carson Wentz, we'll see you a little bit later.
Huh? That's the story. It's a big game. He's got to play well and if they want to keep their playoff hopes alive at all.
And for me, it's the battle of the NFC North, first place in the NFC North, and it doesn't involve Aaron Rodgers. And you look at this game, you got the Monsters, the new Monsters of the Midway against the Purple People Eaters. And this is exactly why they brought these two quarterbacks here. You go out and get Kirk Cousins to win the North and compete for a championship. And on the other hand, the Bears traded up. They traded up to get Mitch Trubisky. He's looking the part right now, but this is what it's all about, is you have to be able to win these games if you're these kinds of quarterbacks. I can't wait to watch this one.
And for me, guys, it is the game of the year, and that's Monday night. The Monday night game, Chiefs-Rams. And when we look at it on the surface of it, we're talking 2-9-1 teams. But I'm telling you, this thing is much bigger than that.
Bigger than that.
I mean, the seer in me sees so much more in this game. This is going to be incredible because we have been cheated. We watched the great matchup of Peyton Manning and Tom Brady. But we could never see that matchup on the biggest stage, even though it was our biggest matchup. But this matchup right here, this Patrick Mahomes and Jared Goff, number one and number two in pass yards, number one and number three in passing TDs, and tied for number one in wins. For the millennials.
Oh, jeez. Oh,
this God. Generation, the millennials, you will have the opportunity to watch the greatest two quarterbacks, young quarterbacks, possibly match up on the biggest stage one day, right there in the Super Bowl, because they are in different conferences. We never got that out of Peyton Manning and Tom Brady. We got cheated. They're getting blessed. They will have that opportunity. And I tell you, I believe it will happen, and it very well may happen this year. So watch this game. Don't watch this game with a short eye. Watch it with the long eye. And know that you are seeing the beginning of something great here today. When we watch this game Monday night. Yeah, Kurt, I had to put my shoe up there.
Is that just an opportunity to show off your shoe?
Absolutely, it's an opportunity to show off my shoe.
Reminds me.
And the M that usually stands for Michael stands for millennials. This time, you are blessed.
I love the hype. Two guys that have never won a playoff game. I love it, though. Nice. I love it. Let's build it up. I hope it works out like
with
that.
With Hanukkah right around the corner, reminds me to tell Suze to get me those monogrammed sequin diamond loafers.
Yeah, there you go, buddy.
Yeah, I like it.
Right for you right there, buddy. You'll get a
look
shot
at that.
You'll get a shot
nicely
right
done right,
right there.
Oh, my God.
Right there.
Okay.
Let's get
quite honestly, don't know how to follow that. but let's get our first report from the field. In New Orleans, don't let the quaffed hair fool you. He lost some of it watching that Maryland Terrapins go for two yesterday. Good to see you, James Palmer.
I appreciate that, Rich. Now, we know the Eagles get after the quarterback maybe better than anybody else in football. And keep an eye on this Saints offense, who's given up just 9 sacks this season. They'll be without left tackle Tron Armstead, but the Eagles do get their right tackle in Lane Johnson back for this game. Now let's go to Tiffany Blackman in Atlanta.
James, Cowboys owner Jerry Jones said, "We don't want another Atlanta to happen to us." He was referring to that November loss last year that happened right here on this field. The Cowboys, though, right now sitting at 4-5. Quarterback Dak Prescott said, "Our backs are still against the wall. We control everything in front of us." Nata Diggy Kikabala in Jacksonville.
Tiffany, in two games versus the Jaguars last year, Steelers quarterback Ben Roethlisberger had 7 turnovers. That's why Jags defensive end Calais Campbell told me this week he expects Roethlisberger is coming down here looking to embarrass the Jaguars. As Campbell put it to me, I sure would be. Now let's go to Baltimore and Tom Pelissero.
Aditi, still no official word from the Ravens about their starting quarterback, but players do expect Lamar Jackson will take the majority of snaps today in a big game against the Bengals. Is the rookie ready? Receiver Willie Snead told me, "I've definitely seen him make every throw, and we have confidence he's going to do that." Let's go to Ian Rappaport.
Well, Tom, let's stick to your game for a second and talk about the Bengals receiver situation. I'm told that John Ross, who's questionable with a groin injury, is expected to play today. Meanwhile, A.J. Green, who missed last week with a toe injury, listed as doubtful, so he probably won't play, but a very good sign that he's actually going to work out before the game just to see if he's got his chance. That is a good sign for next week. And a player who is making a big return today, Chargers Pro Bowl defensive end Joey Bosa. He has missed the entire season. This is going to be his debut today against the Denver Broncos. He had a foot injury, then he aggravated it, had a bone bruise, has not played yet in the regular season, got out to practice, Rich. I'm told he looked great and is expected to play somewhat limited snaps today.
Okay, so it's Ohio State week in more ways than one right now, as you can see. So Marvin Jones and Chris Thompson, keep an eye peeled for their availability. A.J. Green's doubtful, same with Joe Flacco.